Hi, my name is Mike Bayo with Bangert. In today's live stream, we're going to be discussing manual payments and one-time vendor use inside the Sage Intacct for Construction Accounts Payable module. One note before we get into it is I will be demonstrating this solution through the Intacct 2023 Release 2, which is slated for release in May of 2023. And more specifically, the scenario we're going to be discussing today is the scenario where you do not have a accounts payable bill in the system yet, but you need to get a check out the door. You need to record a check that you've already written manually, maybe by hand outside of the system, or you need to record an electronic payment that happened or a credit card payment that happened. In all of these scenarios, you do not have an accounts payable bill in the system yet, but you would like to record that in the system to track the history and to expense it and cost it to a project real time at the same time as writing the payment. If you have an accounts payable bill in the system, you could simply go into accounts payable, bills, and you'll be able to see and filter on your open bills. And if you have an invoice already in the system, for example, office supply store, you'll see a pay button you can click on the right of the invoice here. And you can click on that and you can record a payment. And this bill is on hold, but let me find another one. You can record a payment directly off that system, off that AP bill, right from here, and you'll notice it pulls up the invoice. And then you have all the flexibility that I just mentioned as far as what payment method is this? Is this an actual check you're gonna print out? Is it a credit card transaction? Is it just recording a manual check? Or is it actually an ACH file you're gonna send out? So you have all that ability in the system directly through AP bills if there is a bill previously entered in Intacct. In this scenario, we don't have anything entered in the system yet. So what we're gonna do is this is really gonna be used to record the invoice expense and the payment at the same time. And you'll do that under Applications, Accounts Payable, Manual Payment under Payments section. So you can add a new one on the fly by hitting the plus button. So let's go ahead and do that. And from here, you'll get a manual payment screen. And it will give you some messages. So in this case, it's saying, hey, your payment method is check. These are pre-printed checks. So make sure you have the proper check number listed here. So you do have the ability to do any of the following. So, you know, need a check to print, you can do it right through here. You wrote a manual check, but you want to record it. And all of these are based on payment methods. So you see here, if you need to print out a physical check, you can use the payment method of check, and the system is going to print out a check. So you'll notice you have save and print here. This would be a scenario where somebody comes at the door, needs a check immediately, you don't have anything in the system, and you want to be able to crank a check out as fast as possible. And we'll do that scenario today. Some of the other scenarios is you may have, someone out may have had a blank check or have written a check outside of the system, and now you need to record that in here, get the cost in the system, and then record the payment, the check. Now in that scenario, if it's an actual physical check that they wrote manually and you do want to record it as a check with the proper check number, you can also use the payment method of check. It's going to print a check form to PDF, but you don't need to print it out. It's already been printed. But now this is a good way to get that check number back in line if it isn't in your regular series of check numbers. Now let's say, for example, you don't need to record the actual physical check number. So I just need to record the payment. It happened outside of the system. You know, either physical check or maybe an online payment or electronic payment. I just need to record it. That payment method you're going to use here is called record transfer. This is going to record the payment, but not require any physical document to print out like a check. So you'll notice when I switch the payment method, It then says, okay, what bank do you want to use? So I'll grab the bank. And then I can come down into here and fill some information in. You'll notice the required fields are with an asterisk. So I need to put in the payment date, the vendor, and let's just say it's Lowe's in this case, and we'll talk about vendors in a second. And let's say the transaction amount was for $200. If there's a document number associated with this payment, maybe an invoice number, maybe a payment reference number, you could fill it in here. Notice it's not required in this scenario because it's just an online payment, but we'll just say there is a invoice number 4567. And again, just to clarify, this is a payment document reference number. So maybe like an electronic reference number, a check number. This isn't the vendor's bill number. So this would be your document payment number. Maybe you just want to call it EFT. Okay, something like that. Down here, it shows you who you're paying it to. This is where you can record the vendor's bill number. You can attach a file. So maybe you want to attach the image of the receipt or the, you know, the online transaction. So now once you have that header information in, you can go down to the entries tab and you could turn on and off columns as you see fit here with more actions, edit entries layout. But we want to code it to a project. So we're going to come into here and code this to the San Antonio project. What cost code? This is going to be your list of cost codes. And we'll just say we have some, we got some fasteners and it's materials. So that's going to drive your cost of sales material account. You could put it to the general ledger account according to what you need to charge it to. It will pre-fill in the amount. I've chosen to put the location and department dimensions on here. I can code to department, and this can also be pre-filled by the project. And then also a memo in case I wanted to put some notes on what this is for. Okay, so you can fill that in. So in one entry screen, now I'm going to be able to record the payment for $100 to Lowe's. And I'm also going to be able to get the cost in the system. And I'm going to be able to see a history of that payment to that vendor in the system. And then I would say save and confirm. And when I do that, that's going to post into the system. And I have a bill number. My system is requiring a bill number in this case. So we're going to fill one in. We'll just call it that. But you don't have to have that turned on here as well. So that will show a record in the manual payment screen now, once it posts into the system. And the payment was created successfully. And now it keeps you in the screen. You could do another one. So if you did want to see that list, if I go into manual payments again, instead of hitting the plus button, if I just hit manual payments, it will show up, the record will show up here. This is going to show up posted in your general ledger and projects area as well as a cost in the system. Okay. So now a lot of times what happens is, someone comes in the door, you don't have them in your system, they need a check written, they're delivering or something. Plans, things like that. So we need to get a checkout fast. So let's go and click add here. And the vendor is not, and we do want to write a check. So we're going to leave the payment method on check. It's going to come out of this bank. And if I type in the vendor and we'll say Joe's Delivery, and nothing pre-fills in the system. So when I hit tab, it's going to say, hey, they're not in here. Do you want to add them? So what you have the ability to do here is set up a vendor on the fly, but have the option of not including it in your normal day-to-day vendor list. Otherwise, you're going to be setting up vendors left and right, and you're going to use them one time, and that's it. They're in your system, and your list becomes huge. So what you can do here is you can put in the vendor's name. You can click, do you want to add it? Okay. And when you get into this vendor screen area pops up, the only thing you're required to key in is the vendor name and the print as, which does pre-fill down as the vendor name. So if we come into here and we're going to put in Joe's Delivery, Okay. So you'll notice down here, Joe's delivery pre-filled in. You have this button here called one-time use. And if you do not want to add this to your everyday vendor list, you can check this box. That'll keep it off your vendor list when you're entering data and when you're seeing them on your screen. But it retains a record of it so you can report on it at a later time. Now, depending on what else you need on the check, for example, if the address is required on the check, you can fill the address in of the vendor if you want. And there's also another nice button down here called exclude from the company contact list. So we don't even want this on our overall main company contact list. So you can exclude that as well. Or if they're an individual person, you can check that off. But the main thing you need here is going to be, sorry about that, let me close this. It's going to be your vendor name in the system. And there is more information. You have full ability to track information just like you would a normal vendor in the system. Additional information, if it's 1099, if you're required to pay a 1099. So what's nice is they can be a one-time use, but you can still set them up as 1099 vendor as well. Okay. You're probably not going to come down here and fill this information out, but what you might do is under payment information, what's their typical, they require a check or they require an ACH. So you can set that up if you want to, you don't have to. They have an account number here, stuff like that. So let's just say that's fine. It's a one-time, it's Joe Delivery Service. I'm going to click save. Okay. That'll populate that in the vendor, the pay to, and now I can proceed as I did earlier with this payment. So just to give you an idea of how it shows up in your vendor list, I have another tab open here with my vendor list. I'm going to refresh it because we just added that. And what you'll notice is there is a button on the top called include one-time use. Okay, so right now, if I sort this in vendor name and go down to the J's, actually, let's just do this. What's nice with these fields here is I can just type in J and it'll show me all the J vendors. You'll notice Joe's Delivery Service does not show up there. But if I click include one-time vendors, number one, you'll notice another column becomes available so you can see it here. And then if I do J, there's Joe, and he's checked as a one-time use, okay? So what's nice is, hey, we're gonna do a bunch of work with Joe now. You can go into Joe and turn them off and add them to your main list at any time. So one-time use vendors are there for you to use at your will, and use them however you see fit. But getting back to the manual payment, we're gonna print an actual check. Let's say it's for $75. The next check number, we actually are going to print a physical check. The next check number is 10006. And we'll just call it today's date for the bill number. And we're going to code it to the project. Now, you don't need to code it to a project. Maybe this is just for office supplies or something like that. So let's just grab office expense. So notice I just typed in the name of the account number. I don't need to know the number, office expense, posts and delivery. We'll put it to that, and it's going to be department of, maybe we had an office or overhead department here, but we'll leave it off. So basically now, once I fill the information in, I can click save and print. And when I do that, it's going to actually pop up the check form. Now mine's a void because I'm in demo data, but this is where you would then put your check in the printer and click the print button. Okay. Make sure the check prints properly on the form. Everybody always clicks confirm and then they don't realize that the check didn't print out properly. Someone else was printing something, etc. And then they have to void the check payment. But just wait till the check is confirmed and printed. And then basically what you do is from here, you click confirm. And that's when it's going to post it into your cash management and, through the general ledger and job cost if you have that as well. So when I click confirm, that was actually posted, and I can do my next one here. So if I come over to my manual payments now, you'll notice I have two, and that has been posted. And if I go take a look at my bank register, which I can actually do from here too, let's go to register checks, or I can do it in cash management. Let's go to check register. And let's go current month. There's our bank account. And I just want to make sure I show all transactions. Let's just take a look, see what we get. And you'll notice, there you go. There's Joe's delivery service. There's our Lowe's. Okay. And now I basically see that information and it shows that it's not cleared yet. So that you can get to, get through and generate a manual payment through Intacct rather quickly. And then you can determine on if you want to charge it to an existing vendor, set up a one-time use vendor, and it'll be in your system automatically. So this is a nice feature that does pop up and we get questions on a lot. It's not something that you're going to be doing every day, but it's that thing that when you need to do it, you need to do it quick and efficiently when someone's at the door, and you'll be able to do that with Sage Intacct. So thank you very much for joining us today. If you have any comments or questions, please post them below, and have a great day. Thank you.